Hello and welcome to Indonesian News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news in detail. Recently, the High Court threw an order on a public interest litigation that banned use of the national flag made of plastic and paper. The court has also issued an order to spread an awareness to ban such flags. It has been observed that during the national festivals and other important cultural programs, the citizens and students use national flags made up of plastic or paper. After the program, it is seen that the flags are lying on ground and on roads. This amount to an insult to the national flag. In view of this, District Collector Ravindra Thakre appealed to the citizens that on August 15, on Independence Day, people should not use national flag made up of plastic or paper. The Nagpur Municipal Corporation has issued an order that all the slaughterhouses and shops selling meat in the city will remain closed during Pola and Ganesh Chaturthi. According to the notice issued by NMC, all slaughterhouses and meat shops in Nagpur will be closed on Sunday, August 16, on the occasion of Samvatsari Parva Nimitta, on August 18, on the occasion of Pola, and on August 22, on the occasion of Ganesh Chaturthi. The authorities have appealed to all the meat shop owners to follow the orders or else face charges by Nagpur Municipal Corporation. Central Railway has launched an intensive cleanliness drive for a week from 10th August to 16th August to mark the Independence Day. In this drive, along with cleanliness of stations, trains, colonies, water vending points, toilets, train focus and bin given on tracks. In a major intensive cleanliness drive, number of activities undertaken in all 5 divisions of Central Railways on 10th August 2020. CSMT stations undertook a major cleaning of passengers' coaches, toilets and special trains. Coaching depot staff involved themselves in a cleaning of coaches of all sleeper class and air-conditioned tracks, whereas the station safai karmacharis concentrated on a cleaning of station premises as well as public toilets. Offices premises on terminus platforms were also thoroughly cleaned. Storerooms of a coaching depot were cleaned and material stored to give a clean look. Amaravati district will soon have an independent COVID-19 hospital for women at a super specialty hospital in Amaravati premises where already COVID-19 hospital is functioning, said Shailesh Nawal, district collector and president of district disaster management authority. The decision to establish a separate COVID-19 hospital was taken as it had become difficult to treat COVID-19 affected pregnant women with other increasing number of COVID patients in the district. The hospital will be equipped with oxygen ventilators and also medical officers, healthcare staffers and other facilities also will be made available here. The separate hospital for women will be of 70 to 80 beds. Till date, a total of 21 pregnant women have been detected positive and out of them, 21 have delivered babies, informed Nawal. The collector said the separate hospital will start functioning in the next few days. Advocate Rishabh Agarwal and Suresh Agarwal appeared in the interest of the defendant after the district court issued an ex parte injunction order on July 28. The case was selling a plot in Nagpur to two buyers, Agarwal brothers, after applying their legal acumen and presence of mind. The lawyer duo got a stay on their dispute. Deal with it will be a big to the land mafia.
In a rare instance, especially amid COVID-19 pandemic, a judge at the district court on July 28 granted an ex parte injunction order to plaintiffs Dhruv Rajkumar Gupta against defendant Vijay Tulsiram Dangre after the latter was accused of selling one plot to two buyers in Nagpur. Advocate Suresh Agarwal and Advocate Rishabh Agarwal appeared on behalf of the plaintiff. Applying their legal acumen and presence of mind, the lawyer duo Suresh and Rishabh got a stay on the disputed deal. It was contended that defendant 1 and 2 were hand in gloves with each other and the said sale deed was executed to defraud the plaintiffs of their right. The judge restrained the defendants from alienating the suit plot till filing of say and held that defendants by violating agreement to sell dated July 15, 2016 in favor of plaintiff tried to alienate the suit plot.
To make the market free of infection, Mahanagar Palika Commissioner Tukaram Munde has ordered a COVID test of the traders and their employees. Significantly, the number of corona patients is increasing day by day. Also, merchants are allowed to open market under Unlock 3. During this time, many people visit the shops. Due to this, as a precaution, Munde kept the market free from congestion and no one had any kind of health-related problem. So, ordered a COVID test for employees. On Thursday, Nagpur reported 727 fresh positive coronavirus cases. With addition of these cases, the tally in Nagpur amounted to 11,709, an official said. From the total number of positive cases, 337 are out of Nagpur. With 18 patients succumbing in the day, the fatality count has gone up to 420. A total of 189 patients were discharged in the day, taking the number of the recovered cases to 5,516, it said. Nagpur district recovery rate is 47.11%. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBCN News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take good care of yourself.